But this is also just gonna bring back so much. Oh no, he did his own content cop. He did a content cop on himself. Content cop Idubbbz. Oh no, fuck, he beat me to it. Yeah. Oh, the leafy one. Bro, is it really only 3 years ago? Nah, bro. It can't be. Oh, 'cause he removed him. He's removed him from his channel, I guess, 'cause like all I see content cop Jake Paul. Here's a playlist. Yeah, re-upload.
Uploaded by somebody else, yeah.
Yeah, so he's probably just removed him 'cause the leafy one was like the OG. This content cop on Leafy ended Leafy's career on YouTube. He already had. So the backstory is he was a guy that just had made a shit ton of money, like hosting a private Minecraft world. I'd say a shit ton. He probably made like over 100,000, easily over 100,000. But he was doing these videos like where he would just like shit on a lot of different content creators on YouTube, and a lot of them are like smaller content creators than him. Like he would punch down. September 2016 is when it came out originally, and so he made this content cop on him, and it literally canceled his ass off. And once this came out, it was like, oh fuck, if a content cop comes out on you, you're fucked.
What we do here is go back,
Here
back,
it
back,
is,
back,
intro.
back, 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 back.
Fuck my wife. I'm sort of a cuckold man myself. Please have a great time.
I'm coming to kill you!
Sure has some good fuck me eyes.
OnlyFans has done for me not only financially but mentally and emotionally.
You know what, Elo? I think it's time to bring
killing niggas back.
I love that I can just say nigga back.
Everything I said about Biden is true, you fucking idiots!
Old enough to count, old enough to mount.
What prepubescent
you're using?
Oh my god, bro, the fucking the Hassan, old enough to count, old enough to mount. What?
Have full breasts. They all have full developed breasts.
Nick, you're a fucking faggot.
Hey. Hey.
Straight off the bat, I want to let all the newcomers to my channel know that I'm perfectly fine with bullying. Make fun of
2 hours later.
Autistic or riddled with acne, I don't care. Make fun of him. I think my
all right, sir.
Jesus.
Deuces.
My only stipulation with the bullying is that you also have to not be a pussy. You see, because if you're a pussy and you're hiding your putrid, malformed
girlfriend
behind your hand, your sleeve, or your microphone, you're showing people that you are extremely self-conscious. You're showing people that you're a pussy, and that takes a lot of the oomph out of your bullying.
Idubbbz! We all know this guy, right? He really fucking fell off.
Irrelevant!
He used to be.
Oh, it's not by Idubbbz, it's by somebody completely different. Oops, my bad. It's not by Idubbbz. He didn't content cop himself. Somebody else content copped him! Ugh, people had my idea before I had it, you know what I'm saying?
The untouchable, a god amongst men. How did he fall so far? A woman. That being said, now his reputation is.
Yo, that's so funny. That's exactly what I said. You know what? The pussy changed him, and I don't blame him.
dog shit, I can finally say, Content Cop, pretty shit, honestly.
But out of everyone, Idubbbz should not be the one calling me out for it.
Rape is good.
Like, I know I fucked up, but like, Idubbbz really, out of everyone to call me out, just gotta call me out.
Well, you have some pretty horrible comprehension, because I was hardly calling you out for it. I used it as a point to illustrate that you can be criticized for it.
That is pretty ironic that your friend and someone that was in the video roasting me is someone that does it more than anyone on YouTube. So if you're gonna call anyone out on it, call out PewDiePie.
This isn't Content Cop PewDiePie. What's wrong with you?
Yes, I actually possess no principles. I'm a fucking snake. Idubbbz, you know, he learned and grown at the most financially beneficial time, when his new beliefs just so happened to be the most culturally acceptable. Now, I always thought that learning and growing was about improving yourself, gaining confidence, and evolving as a person.
It's time to... Oh, God, that was a weak-ass burp. Goddamn, I almost shit myself out of my mouth. We gotta go change the title because I'm watching this, so we gotta make sure that we update it. We're in the Content Cop, watching the Content Cop Idubbbz today, folks. Content Cop Idubbbz. Was it 2 Bs? Oh, it was 3 Bs. I thought it was 2 Bs at one point, so. Now, honestly, here's the thing. 100% I agree with what's being said. Is there actually, like, a reaction thing in here, or is it just, like, a... entertainment. We'll just put in the entertainment category. A 100% that makes sense that Content Cop Idubbbz or fuck. It does make 100% sense that right now is when he'd be trying to backtrack on a lot of that stuff that he said back in the day. You know, like his catchphrase being as Asmongold, or well, it is both Asmongold. I don't know if he's actually reacted to it, but Moist Critical said it, that, you know, it's just beneficial for him now that he's doing Creator Clash. You know, his girlfriend does OnlyFans, which probably makes a ton of money, so it would make sense that now would be the best time to be like get ahead of like people trying to cancel him for the shit he's done in the past. But here's the thing, I don't really think anybody gave a shit. I don't think, as far as I'm aware, I did not give a fuck about his older content. Like I said, I really only watched the Content Cops, and that was about it. I'm not saying that's what blew his channel up. I think he was already really popular before that, and as Asmongold has said, and as Moist Critical has said, it was that edgy content back then that really kind of made him super popular. So... it makes sense that right now he'd be trying to backtrack on a lot of the stuff that he said. Plus, also, maybe his girlfriend doesn't like the stuff that he said in the past. So maybe that he's trying to, you know, backtrack for that. But I'm just gonna chill. Oh, I've gotta get a little... gotta get comfortable here. You know what I'm saying? Gotta get a little comfortable. Gotta get a little... Woo!
It is. It's actually about being a really pretentious cunt at all times.
Drama. He likes the drama. Sure. He wants goofy, embarrassing shit.
He wants Jerry Springer.
Yeah.
Right.
Right. Like, that's kind of like Jerry Springer, but with, like, severe head injuries.
How much of a serious event it is and how, you know, you want good fights, safe fights. Yeah. This is what he wants, mm-hmm. which is trashy and lame and pathetic and, like, he's a loser and like nobody will ever love him, stuff like that.
You see, what he does here that's interesting is that he talks about how lame and shit call-out culture is, whilst simultaneously calling out every single person in influencer boxing for being lame and shit. He's learned and grown. All of us are locked into that child mindset, you know, edgy comedy. What are you, a fucking baby? Goo goo gaga, baby man? Comedy is for children. You know it's not for children? Children's toys. This is the guy that I keep getting told has grown up and become an adult. And he's creating Thanos toys to play with whilst his wife takes nudes to go on OnlyFans. But edgy humor is too childish. This man is 33 years old and playing with children's toys, but I'm childish. This pretentious attitude seems to be learned behavior coming from his darling wife, Anissa. Who is Anissa? Well, I'll tell you right now. She's a former anorexic skinny legend who has a background in competitive sports, kinesiology, art history. She's a former police officer trained in weapons. She was raised by a crime family. Expert boxer, boxing promoter. She used to be a fitness model. She ain't like the other girls. She was in the boys' lacrosse team, and the boys' lacrosse team, they were sure as hell in her. And despite all of these accolades, she ended up as an OnlyFans model, and a familial disappointment. She met Idubbbz at VidCon, where she went to dinner with him, fucked him, and then broke up with her boyfriend, replacing him with a richer one. Now, I'm not saying she a gold digger, but she a gold digger.
Damn!
It's a very obvious superiority complex, which seems to stem from massive insecurity because she's a complete fuck-up.
I'm glad I finally became more able to film / take pictures of my body. I feel like a weight has been lifted off worrying about what other people are so what I feel someone would place in. I was truly able to find myself. I had no idea what I was going to be able to do. I love myself. I love myself.
She's not like the other girls, guys.
She spends most of her time on Twitter fishing for validation from her fans. She's a chronic clout chaser.
Yora, I've been scrolling through my own Twitter feed, and I'll read something, and I'll be like, fuck, I need to unfollow this guy. And then I'll go to his page, and then it says 400k followers, and then it says, Sky follows you. And my inner piece of shit goes, this is an important human being. I shouldn't unfollow him. I should just...
Boy, she's right. I should have known the girl that would be stupid enough to say the good things came from the Holocaust would be just as stupid to lay her whole social climbing philosophy right on the table for everybody else.
And much like Idubbbz, she can't help putting herself above everyone else.
Yeah, before I was a student at the University of Alberta, I actually was in policing. I wanted to be a police officer for a very long period of time. I really believed that being a social worker on the streets was what I was made for. But my father really didn't want me to be a police officer, so that dream quickly ended.
She says she has a background in competitive sports through high school.
Yeah, she did sports growing up, so yeah. Like
hockey,
oh my goodness, and everything.
But she also says she was so cripplingly anorexic at the time that she had no energy to do out of school activities.
I was sleeping at 6 p.m. and waking up at, you know, 8 p.m. 8 a.m. to go to school, and that was my life. I had no life outside of school because I couldn't stay awake.
She probably has like close to a million examples of her just flagrantly lying about her own life to make herself out to be some kind of superhero strong woman, like a mythical beast.
I was groomed at 13 years old by a 27-year-old man online, and it fucked me up a lot mentally, and I was taken advantage of as a child by a grown adult. When I tell young girls to avoid older men, it's because I'm trying to protect them from what I went through. 18 and 31 for me. Oh my god, that's awful. That's awful. You were groomed? Aww. At 18? Awful. Awful.
I was gonna say
philosophy master's student who thought life was
the first one I was gonna say, wow, that's really fucked up that happened, but and then she comes in and I'm just like, bro, if you're getting groomed when you're 18, that's on you for being an idiot. I'm just saying, you're an adult. You're an adult at 18, and actually, I'd argue you're an adult at 17, because if you got arrested and charged with a felony, they would try you as an adult if you're 17. So, just saying, I mean, hell, they've charged fucking 14-year-olds, 15-year-olds as adults. So,
pointless just and told me when his friend committed suicide he thought it was funny. And that really messed me up for years dealing with existential dread. The black pill rhetoric is what permanently fucked you up. Not the rape that happened at 16 or the drugging that happened in the same year. No. It was the black pill rhetoric. She once bragged on Twitter about having an abnormally powerful heart. She literally cannot go 2 seconds without making everything about her. She once leaked an allegation of rape against a Twitch streamer, and then uses said allegation to complain about people memeing on her for having an OnlyFans. She ain't like the other girls. Let this woman into your bank account right now.
I'm just saying, I don't really understand why people subscribe to OnlyFans accounts when you could find like a million free pictures on the internet of girls who look just as good as her. It's just because people have this weird like relationship with certain content creators. It's like, oh shit, you know, I watch this person every day. I've gotten to know this person, even though they haven't gotten to know you. You've gotten to know this person, but now you can, oh, I can go look at their OnlyFans. I can beat off to them naked or something. I actually don't know if she posts full nude content, because believe it or not, wow, I don't go to OnlyFans when I could just watch porn for free.
Hey, but Steve, don't you feel sorry for them? Don't you want to commit right away and give them the access to your bank accounts?
Let her in. What's the worst she can do?
Yeah, you mentioned you got to start earning money again. Are you guys not earning anything right now?
No.
Oh, boy.
We have not earned money for the past 2 years.
She has an inability to empathize or take accountability for anything she does.
Yeah, before I was a student at the University of Alberta, I actually was in policing. I wanted to be a police officer for a very long period of time. I really believed that being a social worker on the streets was what I was made for.
Yeah, I do. Do not sign up for something that you do not want to do. My parents were like, well, too bad you don't know what you want to do. You're going to go into something. And they pushed me into policing, and it got me nothing. It was a giant waste of time.
Her career's failing, so she blames either incels or other streamers. Her relationship problems, they're all Idubbbz' fault. To quote Anissa, it's his fault, not mine. Why would you fucking marry this woman?
I was raised by a single mother. I made a lot of friends with like the weird kids. There were guys who were also raised by single mothers.
I don't know what that's from. I'm going to assume it's from Doctor Who, because that's Christopher Eccleston, so I'm assuming that's probably from Doctor Who. I mean, listen, there were definitely, like, a lot of weird, edgy kids. I was always, like, I don't know, like, the group hopper. Like, I was friends with people from all kinds of different friend groups when I was in school, and my close friends that I'm still friends with to this day, you know, I mean, I made friends with them when I was in school, but I wouldn't really classify them as, like, the weird kids or anything like that. But they were definitely, like, the weird kids that were into some weird shit. When I was in high school, there was this kid who got expelled for looking at bestiality on the school computers. Like, he brought in his own thumb drive with that shit on it.
Do you have a really horrible wife?
Yes.
Is she disgusting and horrible and just really busted up looking?
Yes.
Well, come on down to Bungie's Women Emporium for all your feminine needs.
We got black women. We got white women. Yeah, we got Jews. In fact, here's one of our girls now. Say hello, Chantel. Ha 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 ha
ha. She's stupid.
So contact us today and take control of your life now. She is.
Was that piss?
Hot take, Idubbbz' old content was not political. This is one of the tactics that these new reformed creators use, where they try and claim that their old audience was alt-right, and that they don't like them now because they're, like, not right-wing.
Part of the problem with why I was going crazy is because I knew that we were garnering a lot of reactionary fans that I fucking hated, And
what
I didn't,
do you mean reactionary thing?
Like a conservative, fucking, like...
Alt-right.
Racist.
Alt-right.
Yeah, racist,
I never really understood what the whole alt-right and, like, left shit meant. I just go with, like, you're conservative, you're liberal, you know, that's, there's, like, really, like, you have conservative, ideals, or you have very liberal ideals, you're, like, a Democrat, or you're a Republican, or you're a liberal. Those are, like, really the, I mean, people just come up with new fucking words all the time, people come up with new shit all the time. I don't really understand the whole, like, whatever that means. I assume alt-right means, like, you know, like, extreme, conservative, like, racist, shit like that. Like, the neo-Nazis, things like that, but, like, I never really understood it. It's just like, dude, people just thought your shit was funny because edgy content was funny back then. Edgy content was popular. Like, 16, 17, 18-year-olds, like myself back in 2013, 2014, like, dude, we were the prime demographic. Like, we were the kids that grew up with the early, like, I wouldn't say the early days of the internet, but, like, the early days of the modern internet. Like, I grew up watching YouTube as a kid. So, you know, I grew up watching, like, Smosh. I'm trying to think of, I don't want to say his name, but Brian Higa, Niga Higa, if you guys, you know, remember his channel. I think he does still do some content, but, like, not as much as he, like, as he used to. I know Anthony, well, I mean, Smosh is still around, and Anthony's doing his thing on his own channel. But, like, you know, people like that, I wish to watch them. Like, Jenna Marbles is somebody who I think was a really nice content creator. They kind of just got canceled off YouTube. She kind of canceled herself, but to be fair, it's probably best that she stepped away, especially with, like, if you could read the room as far as, like, how culture, like, where our culture is going. Yeah, I can understand.
But in actuality, it's just because they're a cunt.
God, I'd like to know who this guy is, man. I hope that man's life is ruined for this. Hey, I don't give a fuck. Give me his name. Yeah, I don't give a shit. I want this guy's life ruined. Are you kidding me?
The moment I knew there was no coming back for Idubbbz was when he did an interview with fucking Hassan Piker, who is quite literally a culmination of every shitty person he ever did a content cop on. Lazy reactions like Jinx, terrible research and biased reporting like Keemstar.
They had like a bunch of fucking Nazis in the kill stream get together and do an 8-hour reaction to my entire stream. Sargon of Akkad joined! Multiple 8-hour streams!
He can dish it out, but he can't take it like Leafy.
I asked to be taken off of LSF. I purposely tried to get myself banned. Actual fucking Nazis were talking about how they want to murder me.
Know that Hassan Piker! I'm coming to kill you!
But like, haha in a
shallow, hypocritical political takes like Tanamonju.
I already give a fuck.
Holy crap! Is that what she looked like back in the day? Oh, that's different from the person I was
fuckload
thinking
to charity. I already give a fuckload to the government. Way more than any fucking wealthy person ever does. And I don't care. I live on a basic necessity budget for the most part anyway, okay? Basic necessity, and you live in $1 million house rich? Oh my god. Oh my god. Brain dead. No,
I feel like if I had the money, I'd probably go buy, like, a decent house. I'd probably, like, $300,000 house somewhere and just, like, just build from there. Like, I don't understand why people want $1 million houses. They want to live the life of, like, celebrities, but without celebrity budget. And it's pretty rare that a content creator stays relevant for long enough that they'd be able to make enough money to keep that kind of stuff up for a long periods of time. And actually, probably what I would do is, if I had a lot of money, is I would go buy some land somewhere and build like a fake house. And then actually where I would live is in like a super secret, like, underground bunker. Like, I would build like a fallout shelter type bunker underneath the house that has like a super elaborate, I wouldn't say super live, but like a cool, like, hidden door behind like a bookshelf type thing where you have to do like the right code with the books.
Talking about fucking shelter. Fundamentally, the reason why Jeff Bezos, Mark Zuckerberg, Elon Musk give money to philanthropy is unironically to stop people from thinking the way that you're thinking about them. I already give a fuckload to charity.
Constantly flexes on his own audience like rice gum.
La la la, wait till I get my money right.
As a matter of fact, you were probably like more towards the center or left than most content creators of that era, because you were shitting on the most like right wing content creators of that era. Maybe not like a.
See, here's the thing. Here's what's so funny, right? He's like listening to Hassan talk, and I guarantee you, he has no fucking idea what he's talking about. He's like, huh, very center, right? More left than some of the, what did he say, the alt-right? Let's go back real quick.
Of that era, because you were shitting on the most like right-wing content creator.
Most right-wing. I just don't really understand what that word means. I feel like I don't really understand what that means. Dude, I'm telling you, I'm the pause champ. I am the pause champ. I mean, just look at this. Like, look at Idubbbz's wife. She looks confused. Idubbbz looks confused. Like, I'm confused as to what's going on in the fucking moment. Oh, god damn. I'm so sorry. That came out of me like a fucking bat out of hell. Oh, shit. You know, like, everybody that is in this interview with Hassan is fucking confused. So, like, here's the thing. I think, ultimately, Idubbbz shouldn't be fucking embarrassed about the content he made. But you gotta understand, man. You were making some, I wouldn't say some fucked up stuff, but... Let me just do this real quick. I'm just trying to get my, Sorry about that, guys. Pretty sure I have one of my knives over here somewhere, I thought. I was honestly just about to cut these things off. Because it wasn't ever bothering me. But, like, it's really super funny because... They all look confused. Like, they both look confused as fuck. Like, what are you talking about right now? Sorry. I was trying to do it without moving the fucking pillow behind me, but... I'm about to just go look this shit up, because I honestly don't really know what some of these words mean. Like, what the fuck does he actually... Like, what does it actually mean to be alt-right? It says it's a political ideology, which I fucking assumed. Alternative right. Says it's really just it's largely a online phenomenon. It originated during the late 2000s before increasing in popularity during the mid-2010s. And establishing a presence in other countries and then declining since 2017. The term is ill-defined, having been used in different ways by alt-right members, media commentators, journalists, and academics. So, he was right, like, racists and other shit like that, like neo-Nazis, things like that, people it said on the wiki page, on a webzine, which is just a web magazine, by a white nationalist, a white supremacist, I assume. Now, I say that, but nationalist is more, I think, of, like, a country thing, so... So it just is hilarious because you see Idubbbz's face and it's just like he is just as confused as I am right now. So let's just keep playing the video. So yeah, it's just confusing. Like, I don't really.
Creators of that era, maybe not like officially positioning yourself as that, right. But it did feel like. I mean, you were like. You dunked on Keemstar, Rice Gum, like...
White Supremacist Jinx Reloaded, yeah. Called out that white...
See, he is just as confused as everybody else.
Supremacist who didn't like...
I think the only two people that he did content cops on that were white were Leafy and Keemstar.
You saying racial slur, the N-word.
Do I run? Do I scream? Do I cry? Do I hide?
Oh, maybe
I
he did it. Maybe he did it on...
I don't know what to do. He's just looking at me like... with the creepiest, most terrifying...
Oh, yeah, he did do one on her,
smile. And, like, the camera girl is just looking at me like...
Yeah, that fucking Nazi bitch. If you think about it, when he said that Leafy had no chin, in a way... That was socialism. When reforming your image, the first thing you should do is take on the most shallow, basic political takes, such as racism bad. Hitler? That's a no-go. It might just look like pandering, but everybody has the capacity to grow, including Joseph Mengele.
As terrible as the Holocaust was, obviously it was horrendous and how disgusting the...
As bad as the Holocaust was, it was just a prank, bro. Oh my god. I'm so sorry. At the fucking at the goddamn Holocaust fucking trial, at the trials, the fucking war crime trial. What was, I don't even know what they, I can't remember what it actually where it actually was, but they're just like, I'm sorry, I am sorry, it was just a prank.
Doctor was down. A couple of really groundbreaking discoveries.
Let's see what Joseph Mengele did. Ah, here we are, under human experimentation. The experiments he performed on twins included unnecessary amputation of limbs. Many of the victims died whilst undergoing these procedures, and those were sometimes killed and their bodies dissected. But, you know, on the bright side, Mengele's research subjects were better fed and housed than the other prisoners, and he introduced himself as Uncle Mengele and offered them sweets.
Yep, look at the glass half full. You know what I'm saying?
You know, there is a silver lining. There is always a silver lining to Nazi experimentation. Oh, Anissa, you ditzy hoe!
He had never met a Muslim before, and then he ended up marrying one.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. You ditzy hoe.
He had never met a Muslim before, and then he ended up marrying one.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Yeah, mashallah, mashallah.
I just feel like people say things and they don't really understand what they're saying. Ain't no way that she is Muslim, okay? I'm just saying, if she is, she's disrespecting her religion. Which I don't really care about religions mostly anyway, because I feel like religions really miss the point of what most of their founders were that they were trying to get across. I feel like a lot of people just don't have really lost the true meaning behind what religion is supposed to be. It's supposed to bring people together and help people get rid of those bad parts of humanity. There are or the cover or to fix the bad parts of humans, which are that like evil, that evil side that humans just naturally have. No matter who you are, humans naturally have this evil side to them, and that's the whole point of religion. But anyway, that's a whole nother, I mean, I don't really even have the knowledge to be able to do a debate like that anyway. But yeah, yikes. She says she's Muslim. Oof, I don't know if I believe that.
I taught him the fatia.
Oh,
yeah. Nice. A little bit of poop in there.
This is haram! Haram! Send her to Saudi!
Is that his hand?
I don't think so.
The beginning of the end started when Anissa created her OnlyFans account.
Get out! Idubbbz! Get out! Get out! Get out!
website where you can upload amateur porn. Anything from double penetration all the way over to nude cosplay and everything in between. And I think all of it is cool.
Oh, fucking disgusting.
Bro, that aged so poorly. I mean, listen, I don't really know how I'd feel if I was seeing somebody that had an OnlyFans, but I'll be honest, it definitely doesn't look great. But hey, you know what?
I love my girlfriend, and I'm totally fine with dudes jacking off to pictures.
No! Oh, you bastard!
I mean, listen, I would say I love my girlfriend, too, if she looked like his girlfriend, so, yeah.
Look how fucking red this guy is. You have to be an idiot to watch this, and to genuinely think he's fine with it.
You think these fucking retards would actually do a smidgen of research? Because, like, I did it, and I found the potential hypocrisies in what I say in the past, and it's pretty fucking consistent. I would say skank and slut, but never was that part of my argument. It's just flavor. I don't know why everyone thinks that, like, I made a stand.
This is not a hypocrisy. The real hypocrisy is when Anissa was supposed to hang out with Zoe Berger and shake her ass with all the popular e-whores, but Idubbbz put his foot down and told her not to.
I thought I was done, but apparently two tweets wasn't enough for this girl. You were supposed to come and hang out with me and Celestia after you begged Celestia. I have the Skype screenshots. You begged her to come hang out with me. I didn't know her or you, but she pulled you a favor so that you could come hang out with us. I said yes because why not? The more the merrier. You back out because Idubbbz tells you it's a bad idea to associate with me.
Clearly you didn't want her to whore herself out. Lo and behold, 3 years later, now she has an OnlyFans. What changed? Well, obviously, he learned and growed. During this time, Idubbbz was being called.
He learned and his penis grew hard while he fucked
Idubbbz. It's a simp?
How am I the simp? How am I the simp?
I ain't a simp, I ain't Idubbbz, If my girlfriend wanted to do OnlyFans, she's getting removed.
Why are people calling you a simp?
I mean, thankfully, a lot of well-respected creators were here to defend it. We got guys like Vorsch.
I was having sex with other kids.
Mundane Matt.
How in the fuck am I gonna be a dad? My biggest fear is that I'm not gonna feel anything towards the child.
Bunty Kid.
I'm a cuck. I'm a fucking cuck, guys.
Now these are the guys that you want in your corner when you're facing down the cuck allegations. After the launch of the OnlyFans, Anissa took to social media to celebrate. However, behind the scenes, OnlyFans pictures were immediately spammed across the entire internet for everyone to access.
People paid for that shit, now you get it for free.
So Anissa called in the lawyers to DMCA strike all the content for copyright infringement. She got on a bit of a power trip, started DMCAing Reddit memes, such as this image of her and Idubbbz surrounded by all of her leaked Discord DMs shitting on him, as well as his Instagram versus reality meme. As of today, the attempt to restrict the content...
Nah, bro. Damn, that was violated. Holy shit. Holy fuck.
Instagram versus reality meme. As of today, the attempt to Discord DMs shitting on him. As
holy
well as
shit. That's a motherfucking violation right there. Holy shit. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm so sorry.
Instagram versus reality meme. As of today, the attempt to restrict the content has seemingly been abandoned, as you can find Anissa's OnlyFans near the bottom of the sixth page of Google search, just under fapfappy.com, pussyboy.net, and sexdrug.com. As if me and all the other successful women haven't already gotten our bag and are playing the stock market right now. Anissa, what the fuck are you talking about? What, is fucking George Soros paying you for suck jobs? I would not buy this woman. This woman is not good. This woman is really not good. This woman has a white devil in her pussy. This woman has watched too much CNN, and now she has sex diseases. I would not pay a goat for this woman. This woman is not worth my goat. I give this woman 0 goat out of a possible 10 goat. Before we get too mean here, let's just remember, if you put all your parts on the internet, be ready for some critiques and opinions. What are these tattoos? Are they close to an escape room? Are they reminders for when you inevitably develop dementia? What is this one? Get milk? Will you mind your business someday and some teenagers stumbled upon you and thought you were a wall?
Internet is forever. Archive, future jobs, question mark. To be fair, I'm pretty sure anyone that makes the decision to put nude photos of themselves online deliberately have already weighed these consequences.
Oh no, this is 100% an impulsive decision. There was absolutely no forethought behind this whatsoever. We're talking about a woman who got married because she wanted to shave her head.
What the fuck, man?
Shave your head, bud.
Shave your goddamn head.
And the marriage was so rushed that she couldn't get a US visa for 3 years because immigration control thought it was a scam. That's real. She did all this for dear old dementia-ridden dad. It wasn't just a grasp at short-term relevance. No, no. She did it for her dad's care home costs. It's expensive stuff. It costs $2,000 a month, sometimes $3,000 a month. They found a nice one, but actually they aren't going to put him in a care home.
And that's also why I'm so privileged as a Canadian, and why I think Americans deserve universal health care is, like, my dad gets taken care of financially for any medical needs, and we have something called AHS, which is like assistance where we have someone come over and help my dad, you know, every week, at least like twice a week.
But don't go believing that she regrets OnlyFans just because she bans people from events for mentioning it. It's actually really fulfilling having this guy jerk off to you. Boy, I wish I could be that fulfilled. Her family has always been supportive of the OnlyFans. Her brother Muhammad, he loves it.
Spread it, sis.
He's always been supportive of it. Doesn't stop her from shit talking him on Twitter, though. The one thing I'll give Anissa is that it was
damn, that shit just
doesn't stop. From shit talking him on Twitter, though. The one thing I'll give Anissa is that it was.
Damn. I mean, shit talk your own family to your family, but damn, you put that shit online? That's fucking embarrassing.
Very thoughtful to wait until your Islamic father had fully succumbed to dementia before you started. Because if I were in his position and my.
She better hope her dad doesn't actually stumble across her OnlyFans and forget that's his daughter.
My daughter started an OnlyFans. I too would want to be riddled with dementia. Or preferably dead. Because you don't want to become lucid and find out about your daughter's OnlyFans.
I gotta get away from these fucking people. I never thought I'd see my daughter's condition. I knew she was crazy. Ever since I caught her hiding helter-skelter inside the family Quran.
Ever since the OnlyFans, Idubbbz audience have been theorizing that he lives a sordid and depressing life. This usually elicits an angry response from HREE fans who lack the amount of emotional intelligence required to determine that this man probably isn't happy. I just like watching the Ethan Klein comments and seeing people be like, oh, Anissa, she loves him so much. She puts her like hand on him to like comfort him. And I watch that clip and I think that is clearly a threatening motion. That's like the shit that Homelander does that. You know what I mean?
Yo. Oh my God. Facts. Oh my God, dude. Facts. You can just see he does not look right, man. He does not look right. Idubbbz looks fucking not okay in that video clip. That one they keep sharing where he's got like the super big bags under his eyes. Like, I don't know what the fuck that guy got into, man.
Bullshit.
I'm not gonna lie, Ethan. I go to your subreddit all the time for like a break from the insanity. It's like the only sane place on the internet, I swear to God.
I was thinking about this recently. I'm a guy, to preface. I used to not really be into Idubbbz content at all back in the day. It was very edgelord.
Yep.
He was a more progressive guy due to certain things he would throw
in. I
love
that. I can just say
I did love
faggot.
The Ian and Ethan colorblind video erupted by a woman. They think that if she was never in the picture, then Ian would have stayed the same and would be, I don't know, saying the N-word still? And something is wrong. This is a very instilled concept at a young age for a lot of men. If not, like, I see myself in him in that sense. If it weren't for the stronger, more vocal women in my life, I'd probably be much, much different. Ian and Ethan grew up. They didn't. Idubbbz says ever since he got with Vanessa, he cries more.
I've hit a point recently where I cry a lot more often.
Aw, that shit's hard.
Doesn't his wife or his girlfriend do OnlyFans?
Yes.
From really weird shit, too. We watched the Puss in Boots movie.
And that hit you?
I cried, like, probably three different times in it.
He also apparently frequently dissociates from reality and enjoys doing so.
I love to just check out.
Oh.
Just randomly. Oh. Maybe, like, when I'm driving.
Oh, maybe. That's called dissociation. That's a different thing.
Yeah.
That's not meditation.
Yeah, I love doing that.
Now, I'm not a doctor nor a scientist, but I don't.
I think Anthony actually is kind of worried for him right there.
Now, I'm not a doctor nor a scientist, but I don't think that frequently dissociating from reality is a good thing. How fucked up do you have to be to enjoy your manic episodes? The real horror of this relationship comes through in any interview he's ever done on the H3 podcast, run of course by Ethan Klein, former EDP collaborator, where Anissa stands next to him like a she-devil, speaking for him whenever she gets the chance.
I also take ownership for the Tana. The Tana thing was my...
Oh, that was so long ago.
Was my idea. Was my stupid idea.
The Tana thing was my idea. Idea, not Ian's. A lot of guilt put in him.
Really harassed.
I was entertaining. I could also recognize why it was completely out of line.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
And there's like some.
But actually, I'm pretty sure all of his content cops are gone because I was looking earlier. I couldn't find any of his content cops. All of them were.
Have all of them gone.
Holy shit, I'm only halfway through this.
Your life. Like, I feel like some... Because you get so many messages. Ian, as a person, has not changed very much in, like, regards to his, like, moral stance on a lot of things.
I mean, you could just say, like, you know, I made a lot of this stuff because it was edgy and it got a lot of views. And you could say I did it for the content. And then you could just... You could dip, like, literally it's called content cop. Like, you could just be like, I just said a lot of that stuff because I was an edgelord and I've changed. And that's just... You could just... say that and not say all this other cringy shit, and you could just, that could be your narrative. I was just an edgelord, and I, you know, I thought that shit would get me a lot of views, and it did, and I cultivated a fan base, and then, you know, I just kind of, like, got a little bit older, you know, I just stopped hanging out with certain people, I stopped, you know, saying a lot of that stuff, and then you'd be like, I grew up, you know what I'm saying? Like, you could just say that, and instead of all this shit, but, you know, it's kind of hard when he would have shit on himself back in the day. The guy that he is now, he would have gotten a content cop on.
But like Ian and how he feels about how he wants to put himself on the internet has changed.
Mm-hmm. But I think that was gonna happen no matter what.
That's what he always says.
Anissa, shut up! What do you even do, Anissa? You keep saying we. What the fuck do you do? You can't cook, you can't clean. I've seen the inside of your house. You've actually got dog shit caking your floors. The reason Idubbbz stays with this she-bitch is because she was the first ever real girlfriend he ever had. He's dated girls before that. Fans, may I add, Ethan Klein. But Anissa was the first girl he properly dated. He didn't ask me anything back in 2016, and he said that he was a virgin. That might have been a joke. But I don't know. It seems like he'd do anything to stay with her, like abandon his happiness and self-respect. This is a thing that happens with dudes who don't have any sense of self-worth. So this is my advice to Idubbbz section. Women want guys who set boundaries. They don't want guys who are like, I'll do anything. I'll do anything to stay with you. Just give me a second chance. I'll do anything. Because women who want relationships like that, they fuck dogs, you know? You should... Women who want relationships like that, they fuck dogs.
Holy shit, somebody put that on the internet? God damn, some people boundaries are dumb as
in
fuck.
Your relationship, Idubbbz, because the relationships are built on trust, and if you don't have boundaries, then there is no trust, right? Because there's nothing to break. If your partner can get away with anything, there's no trust.
Finally, I can finally pay attention. There's some GTA 5 content going on.
Not to fuck of a man. The way Idubbbz talks about himself now makes me think that he was a nervous wreck.
Those videos, like you said now, they were a hit piece, and when you look back at it, you cringe at it.
Absolutely.
It's not something that could have been sustainable even if you wanted to.
Look, if you didn't change,
you couldn't.
You'd just be, you'd be Keemstar.
Holy shit. I see, this is the thing, right? I stopped watching H3 for, I mean, really after they started the podcast, or they started the H3 podcast, I stopped watching Ethan and his channel. So it's no surprise to me that he kind of copied the content cop, because Idubbbz just stopped doing them, I'm pretty sure, after the Keemstar one, I think, was the last one he did.
Well, when you start interacting caring with the actual world, and you're not in your bedroom creating sitting in your bedroom for 19 hours creating a hit piece on someone, and you actually interact with human beings, you sort of realize like that isn't really real life.
When he says stuff like that, it doesn't seem like, it seems very much like a him problem. I mean, just because you personally were like a fucking shut-in weirdo who didn't have any friends and didn't interact with people doesn't mean that every single person who does edgy comedy is the same as you, right? That just seems like you're a fucking weird creep. He has falsely associated his social ineptitude with edgy comedy. Idubbbz does a lot of bad things, but I can't help but feel bad for him. This woman he's with, man. I think Anissa is actually a demon. This woman uploaded pictures of her bared asshole to Twitter on their wedding day.
I mean, damn, dude. That's on his wedding day? I mean, come on, man. You gotta at least... See, this is the thing. Nobody has respect for themselves anymore these days. I mean, it's not even like Idubbbz didn't have friends. Like, it seems like he had friends. Like, he had people help him make the content cops, I'm pretty sure. So, it's just like, I don't know, man. My statement at the beginning, when I started watching this, is exactly the same statement that I made before that dude the pussy changed him.
What is more demonic than that?
She is bad as fuck, though, I won't lie. She is fine as fuck.
He's too far gone, there's no coming back. If the OnlyFans wasn't a red flag, if her uploading nudes to Twitter on their fucking wedding day wasn't a red flag, and then he took her last name as well, there's no coming back. For this guy. He's gone for good, it's over. Now, after the more sustainable direction failed, Idubbbz went with another sustainable form of content, Creator Clash, where you get a bunch of has-beens to have a friendly sparring match in front of thousands of people. And did I mention that it's all for charity? The whole charity thing is very obviously supposed to be both a shield against criticism and a way to morally posture over every other boxing event. Creator Clash is literally a pick-me. We're not like the other events, guys. We care about our fighters.
That's the other thing I want to add, is like, we've been, you know, we fly to LA and we're meeting these guys' coaches, making sure that they actually have credible coaches that are like not, you know, fitness boxing coaches. They're like actual guys that are going to, you know, get them in there and sparring. Like, I think the best way to describe what I do is, like, I'm the glue that kind of just, like, needs to be wherever it needs to be to, like, stick things together. And also care about the fighters and check on their progress. And, like, I do the matchmaking. So, like, I'll, like, look at how they're sparring.
Another crazy one was Minx.
We also found out that she had only sparred like 3 times before fighting.
That's horrible. Once you face off with somebody, you're in a fight. Like, these are going to be fights. I don't want people to think that it's going to be fluffy. But you're going to have 2 people that are, you know, in a fight, punching each other.
I didn't expect the level of competitiveness and intensity.
These are going to be fights.
I didn't expect the level of competitiveness.
In our event, all the money goes to charity. Pick us, guys. We're not like the other events. We're not doing lame fake drama. All our drama is real, and it stems from my wife's insecurity about her OnlyFans. Every retard hack creator on this card is just constantly virtue signaling about how much they care about charity, whilst keeping the 100k they're being paid under wraps. Don't want people to know about that one. These people do not give a shit about charity.
I trained twice a day every single day like I did.
He did pretty well out of creator class, didn't he, really?
Yeah, he got a ton of new viewers. Yeah. He's got crazy subs. So it all worked out for him. I won, but I still have no viewers. I had 1,500 when I was playing Uncharted at one point last year after Creator Clash. And then I went on Game Grumps Tour and I came back and I had 20 viewers.
Anissa herself, the organizer, said that if Sam Hyde was on the card, half of these people would pull out of a charity event.
Look, I understand that, you know, Sam might not be on brand, but as far as a show and entertainment, like, yes.
We would lose half the card, though.
I just don't think that's true. I mean, Sam, that's the thing, like, people don't understand is, like, people... That's it. So what's so weird, right, is that like half of Twitch viewers are these same people that were like Idubbbz back in the day. Like, did they ever look at Twitch chat? Because Twitch chat is what Idubbbz was back in the day. Cringy edgelord saying whatever, doing whatever. Sam Hyde's the perfect kind of is the perfect guy you'd want in Creator Clash. I usually don't side with Keemstar a lot on his takes, but this one he actually makes a good point. I mean, Sam Hyde would be the perfect person to have a Creator Clash.
Like, legit, actually. And all the sponsors.
Yeah. So they obviously don't give that much of a fuck about charity. Unless, of course, Anissa was just lying. There's no evidence to suggest that Anissa would ever lie about anything. Now, let's be honest with ourselves here. You've all obviously heard about the Froggy Fresh thing. He made the tamest joke known to mankind. And then Maureen Joma went. Fucking ape shit in the replies. My question is, why is Maureen Joma on Twitter arguing with Froggy Fresh instead of giving her husband his fucking dementia pills? He's sitting in the corner like, eating fucking gemstones and pennies because he thinks they're sustenance. And Anissa has very clearly caused a lot of pain in her own family. Yeah, very clearly. Not okay with the OnlyFans. And it really does not seem like Idubbbz is either. Froggy Fresh gets banned, and...
But, like, I just don't understand what they mean by a risk. I mean, shit, Froggy Fresh, that dude's been around on YouTube longer than Idubbbz has been, so...
The defenders are your standard e-whores and degenerates.
Sam Hyde is a Nazi cunt, and Idubbbz is not obligated to associate with him. Put your big boy pants on and accept that not everyone has to get along with your real pussy. Friends, Paul tweets Cavill saying that the video's not doing too well, and just like that video.
It's so funny nowadays that people just don't like you, they just call you a Nazi. I'm just like, I feel like people say words so much that they just lose the meaning of what they actually were. Like, people say stuff so much that they just lose the original context.
You have to get along with people.
My favorite defense is the, if you chat shit to Vince McMahon, he'll kick you from the WWE defense. Imagine this, The Undertaker, he goes on Twitter and he says, I'll take Vince McMahon's growth hormone if Brock Lesnar beats me. And Vince goes, look, Undertaker, buddy, I know you're the top wrestler, made me millions, but you're fired! Other theories include Sam Hyde indoctrinated Froggy Fresh into the Hitler's Nazis.
And he's just started posting, like, let me see if I can find it. He was just posting Nazi shit, okay? I don't know how to explain it. I don't know how else to explain it.
See what I mean? Like, she just said that, but, like, doesn't understand what it is. So you're saying that he was posting stuff that was, hating on Jewish people? Is that what you mean? Because that's what I know as a Nazi is, was the, people that hated the Jews and fought against the entire world with the Japanese and the Italians during World War II are the same Nazis, same, was posting swastikas and anti-Jewish stuff. I don't know
Other
about that.
He was posting Nazi shit.
Can't show any of that, though, because, you know, it didn't happen. But trust me, it happened. Sam Hyde, he's like a Nazi, he's a misogynist, he's a sexist, and he hates women. He's a Nazi. He's a homophobe. Let me just check here.
Exactly! See? I'm telling you, they've got this fucking list of just catchphrases. Fucking catchphrases, the things they say to make people be like, Sam Hyde's just an edgy person. He's the... Honestly, Idubbbz would have got along with him great back in the day, I feel like.
He's a Nazi.
Oh, yeah. They forgot where they put in hates black people in there. Oh, there's the Nazi, though. I see it. Anti-Semite. There it is. Yeah, anti-Semitic. Racist. Oh, yeah. The Asian variant. The black variant. It's oh, Nazi again. You got to make sure you have it in twice. Ooh. Double up on the... Triple up, quadruple up on the racist. This is the... This is just the generic version here, not the Asian or the black variant. Doesn't wear a mask. Okay, anti-vax. Yep. Old. Ah, yeah, that's always the hardest one. Bigoted against Hezbollah and others of his.
And he doesn't wear a mask, so.
I thought that maybe it's against short people, but I'm not sure. I don't know what that last one was. I couldn't read it.
Ooh, this guy, man, he doesn't wear a mask, for God's sake.
Mm-mm-mm.
I mean,
no
he's
mask,
a Nazi
ooh.
And he doesn't wear a mask. I'll tolerate one, but I won't tolerate both. The videos he posted. I noticed he also started mispronouncing Anissa's name the same way Sam Hyde does, as another subtle sign of disrespect.
I was saying Anissa earlier, and people are like, that's wrong.
Oh my god. Hassan is the alt-right pipeline. I fucking knew it! His full name is Hassan Hitler. They threatened to sue Froggy Fresh, which there was actually no evidence of, but
That's the thing, like, I feel like if you sit there and threaten to sue somebody, or you're saying you're gonna sue somebody, sue them for what? I mean, you put on a fighting event that is supposed to be for charity, okay, with content creators, and then you get mad when these content creators aren't even being mean. They're just trying to drum up some drama between each other because that's what people love. People love fighters. Like, if you look at the UFC or you look at boxing matches, they love when fighters get in their faces, get in each other's faces, drum up drama and all this other stuff. Like, that's what a lot of these, that's what it felt like that he was trying to do. I mean, maybe he probably could have done a little bit better, but that just means that you, that gives you fire to want to kick this guy's ass, right?
Is a dumbass. And actually confirmed that this threat was real. Basically, Froggy got $15,000 for training, which according to Alana Pierce, was taken out of pre-existing charity money.
That money that was given to him is just taken out of charity.
And given to Froggy Fresh, because Idubbbz and Anissa are too greedy to pay him out of pocket. That's what she said. I didn't say that. And when they kicked Froggy Fresh because he trained with Sam Hyde, they sent him a legal threat saying to shut up and give the money back or they would sue him. And the reason he was kicked was because he trained with Sam Hyde. It was confirmed by one of Anissa's deranged friends, Denims.
I've spoken to the event organizers and they've really said that they really, really didn't want to kick him from the fight because they know how hard Chris has been training and they know how hard Chris has been working and how much progress he's made in the boxing space, and they feel really bad pulling a fighter last minute. Their reasoning behind having to pull him is just like, you are associating with this person publicly in a way that is harmful, in a way that's weird. You're attacking, directly attacking the creators of the event, and you think we're gonna say and do nothing? Like, that you could insult the people who are giving you this opportunity, you know? And so, it's pretty sad.
You've heard of her. The biggest female political streamer, Denims. You've heard of her. One of the things I haven't really seen.
I love how you said, you've heard of her. And then I would have just put crickets. Oh, nobody? Oh, right.
Anyone talk about is how Idubbbz and Anissa have relentlessly shit on Dr. Mike following his fight with Idubbbz. Imagine getting slapped around for 5 straight rounds so hard that management shortened the round timers from 3 minutes to 2 minutes during the fight and then still chatting shit.
I also want to make it very clear that the sport of boxing is not all about knockouts. Sorry, Dr. Mike, you don't have knockout power.
Mike's actually quite a bit bigger, eh?
Oh yeah, in every way.
Your punches are like little butterfly kisses.
Dr. Mike's getting his ass pulverized pretty much, which is nice. I like to see that.
They're just shitting on him because he's really popular. People like him, and he's actually a nice dude. From what I can tell from all of his content, he seems like he's a nice guy. I mean, he's in the medical field, so he's obviously got to be relatively nice. But man, dude, this is just man. This is just what happens when you become a hypocrite.
The only time I felt an experience like that is when I'm trying to defend myself from my dog's barrage of kisses. I'm like, oh no, fuck.
Getting his ass beat, or I don't know if it's just cut that way.
No, he is.
And sometimes my dog even hurts me worse than you did.
So he's a fat loser, and you're potentially a fat winner.
Yeah.
We'll see. April 15th, we'll see.
Yeah, his mom died though.
Exactly. Yeah.
Dude, that's really fucked up. That's super fucked up.
I know. Yeah.
Your opponent Alex Wasabi's a giant pussy. You're gonna fucking kill him.
Some people call him Pusabi. I don't want to call him that because I think that's demeaning.
See, that's a little bit of that old Idubbbz creeping back up to the top. You know what I'm saying? That's the old Idubbbz that we know, and I wouldn't say love, but that's the old Idubbbz we know.
Meaning, to women.
Oh, his mom's dead? Settle down, you can't say pussy. Come on now, settle down, you're going too far.
I don't want to call him that, because I think that's demeaning to women.
Yeah, but Joe Rogan's a fucking pussy.
I also noticed that every single person in Creator Clash 1 who wanted to fight again in Creator Clash 2 did, except for two people. Minx, who was on a DAZN fight, and Dr. Mike. And all I'm saying is that he did go on the Brandon Buckingham show, and he did say shout out to Sam Hyde.
Keep it up. We have a sad Sam Hyde at home watching this. Do you want to say shout out Sam Hyde?
Sorry, Sam Hyde, that happened to you.
So, is it really that ridiculous that they may have behind the scenes blacklisted him because of that? I don't know. Ever since the...
They blacklisted Mike. I guess I'll call him Dr. Mike. Because he actually can fight. He's actually in good shape. He actually is healthy because he fucking takes care of himself. And he would have beat anybody's ass out there besides maybe a couple of, like, crazed dudes like that one dad guy that just went in there and whooped some ass. But it's so funny that they blacklisted Sam Hyde. And I wonder why that is, really. It must have been after, like, they clowned the shit out of Idubbbz when he did that documentary with Sam. And they clowned the fuck out of him. And they've talked about it on previous videos. I think they did a video talking about it after Idubbbz did that little documentary with them. Oh no, my camera. Woo, whoops. I need to find my phone stand so I can have that back. They clowned the shit out of him. And so, yeah, I really don't know what the beef is with Sam Hyde, but I would assume it probably stems from that. From them clowning the fuck out of him when he did that documentary with them. Or he did that little video thing, whatever you want to call it.
Creation of Creator Clash. Anissa has added another line to her personality chart. Expert boxer.
Getting his ass beat, or I don't know if it's just cut that way.
No, he is. But do you see how every single time Avila, like, tries to bury his head in his chest?
Yeah.
The whole goal is to get as close as possible because Mike has reach, okay. And when you get close like that, it's really hard to do anything.
Anissa, you literally faked brain damage to not fight Brittany Venti. And I don't blame you. Brittany Venti, she's got the fucking black woman's rage.
Oh my god! Brittany Venti? Dude, holy shit, I have not heard that name in so fucking long. Oh my god, where the fuck has she been? She used to be everywhere. Oh my god, dude, that's like unlocking a core fucking memory for me. Like, holy shit. Oh my god, that's a fucking name I haven't heard in a long time. Oh my god. As soon as they brought this clip up, I was like, holy shit.
She would have killed you. It's all well and good critiquing other people's fights, but it's like, do you really think you should be chatting shit? She faked brain damage, and then she goes, what's a reasonable number of concussions? Oh, 13? Yeah, that's a reasonable amount of concussions to have received in fucking high school sports. The boys on the lacrosse team were literally banging your brains out. Originally, she says 2, then she says 4, and then she goes, fuck it, 13, between the ages of 2 and 18.
I would probably say I've had at least 2 major concussions. One when I was about like 4 or 5. I was just being an idiot, you know, being a typical idiot. I was running through my house and I tripped. I was running like full speed and I tripped. And my sister had the steel daybed and had the steel bar. And I just tripped and I slammed my head straight into it. Top of my head straight into that thing. And definitely was seeing some stars after that. I went to the ER and they had kept me overnight just to make sure I was okay. And then another time, I was a goalie in soccer for my school team. And one time during rec ball, I dove into the goalpost by accident because I wasn't paying attention. I made the save, so, you know, for whatever that was worth. But, like, they used to keep the goals. They had moved them. I don't exactly know why they had moved them, but they had moved them, like, a little bit, like, forward. And I just wasn't paying attention and just fucking went to dive for the ball. Connected with that bad boy. I got up and I just fucking went all my day. Those for sure I probably got concussions off of, but, I guess, you know, I wouldn't say
how
I've had other concussions.
How the fuck did you get a concussion at 2?
I'm putting this section in after the fact because Idubbbz made a response video dragging up all the drama again after it settled down. I want you to bear in mind that this is the guy who's matured, he's learned, he's grown. The reason for kicking Froggy Fresh was, I can't be friends with him because he retweeted someone I don't like. Now, a lot of people seem to think that's not pathetic, which is amazing to me.
Do you think it's appropriate
that, I don't know, a 30-something-year-old man is publicly calling my wife a whore and a slut.
With a young Natalie Portman, take on Ethan, you must be a special kind of fool. Go cry yourself to sleep while your wife gets fucked by Brad the Bull. Who am I even repping against? Ryan looking like...
I guess you're just mad your wife is railed by Brad the Bull all the time. Young Buck.
Having Brad the Bull. My wife wants it every night, morning, and afternoon. I know she's my wife, but Bradley, you can have her too. Because there's a few things I treasure in life. Ponzi scheme, Sue and Ethan and Brad fucking my wife. Bankrupting.
They're fed, suing everybody with daddy's money. Clean Brad's come off wifey's tummy. Lost.
I don't think it's appropriate that you are hanging out with a guy who doesn't think women are people.
He's got all the hallmarks of a grown, mature person. He puts his life, the life of his wife, and the lives of the general public at risk by dissociating from his body whilst driving down the motorway. He cries at the Puss in Boots film. He plays with the Marvel toys. He can't be friends with you if you're friends with someone he doesn't like. He's a 33-year-old man, and he certainly acts like it. People like Tipster have been saying he's defending his wife. And to be fair, Tipster has been consistent on that. If you shit-talk Tipster's wife, he fights two battles that day. One against you, and one to get out the chair. But, because he's a big fat guy. But to be fair, he's not really defending his wife, though, is he? Right? Because Sam Hyde made the comments. Froggy didn't. It's akin to the school bully stands up and he goes, Brendan's gay. And the whole class laughs. And Brandon goes, I have to stand up for myself. I have to defend myself here. So he finds the guy's younger sister and kicks the shit out of her. That was a Chad move. Chad move? Beat the shit out of this young girl? That was a Chad move. Giga Chad over here beating up girls.
Like, you don't get the vibe, all right? The vibe is sex workers and fighting, I guess.
Idubbbz, the only vibe you should be concerned with is the one in Anissa's panty drawer. What I'm realizing about Idubbbz is that his whole career was mocking and belittling people, but he's never actually been mocked and belittled, because the people who got Content Cop never really responded with insults, because there was nothing on him. I think he has this mentality where he thinks...
I think it was mostly because a lot of the people he did Content Cops are, the narrative was already changing against him. People already fucking hated Keemstar because he's a piece of shit. They already hated fucking, what was his name, because he was a piece of shit. People didn't like Tana Mongeau because she was a piece of shit. I'm trying to think of... people didn't like Leafy because he was a piece of shit. I wouldn't say he's a piece of shit. I'll take that back for some of them. But, Rice Gum, sorry, I couldn't think of Rice Gum's name because he's just, it didn't matter. Rice Gum was a piece of shit. Keemstar was a piece of shit. Tana Mongeau was a fucking idiot. Okay, who is it? Leafy was a piece of shit, punching down on all these really small creators and just people that couldn't really fight back because they didn't have the same fan base that Leafy had, and people were harassing them constantly. So if you look at all of the Content Cops, it was all against people that were already, like, notorious in the YouTube sphere. People already didn't like them. So, I mean, that's just the long and the short of it. They didn't, it's not they couldn't fight back. It's just that people already knew that they were pieces of shit. So it's like, or they weren't good people. I shouldn't say pieces of shit. It makes me sound really mean. But they were already weren't good people. So there really wasn't anything that they could do back. It's like, Ethan kind of, I mean, not Ethan. I mean, well, Ethan, I guess, too. But Ian kind of wore that shit on his sleeve. He said the NF slur combo all the fucking time. Like, how are you gonna cancel this guy? He's just a degenerate on the internet all the time. What can I say? Anything you'd Content Cop him on is already out there. You know what I'm saying? You couldn't really hit this guy. But how the mighty have
he
fallen, you know?
Fuck with you, and you're not allowed to, like, fuck with him back. And when you do, he gets, like, really pressed on it.
I think a lot of the content I've made has been irresponsible and misguided. And I think I've hurt a lot of people with the content I've made. And I think I've done a lot of bad. And, you know, at the bare minimum, I've just put a lot of negativity out there in the world.
So he's ashamed of his old content, doesn't want to present himself that way anymore. And yet, his fucking ring walk in Creator Clash 2 is literally a direct reference to his old edgy content. Like, this is the shit he was wearing when he did the fucking I'm gay stuff. But apparently he's ashamed about it. This is either A, he's not ashamed of his old content, right? Or B, he's trying to, like, appeal to his own fans after he's accidentally, like, just fucking completely thrown them all away with the whole Anthony Padilla stuff, with the Froggy Fresh stuff. He's completely alienated his fan base, and now he's, like, doing this to try and, like, appeal to his old fans again. Like, how is this appealing to, like,
his new, like, grown-up, mentally mature fans who don't think a guy in spandex going, I'm gay, is funny. Like, he's obviously not doing it for them. Like, he's doing it for his
fucking still like, funny, though. You do understand it's still fucking funny,
Sam
though.
Doesn't like you. Is because you still funny, tried though. To make a hit piece on him. You were really rude and dismissive to him in Twitter spaces.
I want to see how much better Ian's gotten. I want to feel your power levels, man. So you, honestly, man, you look really good.
Thank
how
you.
Much we've got quite a few people that are they were my dream picks that have said that they're interested, so
yeah.
Who's I your think dream pick?
Well, none of your business, Sam.
If they decide to cancel, me and Sam will definitely do it.
Cool.
That's great.
And you made him lose $10,000 by banning him from the event on the day. Now you're crying that he doesn't like you? Fucking grow up, bro. The context of the Anissa clip is Sam responds. To a live stream where she calls him a scorpion, a snake, and a violent person.
In Anissa's own words, Sam, you are a scorpion, and Ian is a fraud. Some kind of Muslim story fable, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't think so, man. I think it's the opposite, my fellow.
He's the scorpion?
He's a fucking snake. He's got an ego.
It's like I said earlier, actually, it's funny that I brought up that documentary that he did with Sam. He was trying to do a hit piece like he did for Airsoft Fatty, for anybody who doesn't know, right after the content, like after the Content Cop era of his channel kind of like died down, and these people, you know, all of the people he called out were all of the people looking like the biggest, you know, were the people that deserved to be fucking had a Content Cop dropped on them. Which were just shitty people taking advantage of how popular YouTube was at the time. And then he started doing these little documentaries. And he did one on Airsoft Fatty, which, honestly, the dude who... I hate calling him Airsoft Fatty because it just is kind of mean because he's a big dude, both literally and figuratively. But he seemed like he was a really nice guy and just kind of, like, having fun with his life and his buddies. And... Idubbbz kind of went in there and just made fun of him the whole time. And then he tried to do the same thing with Sam, but see, the thing is, Sam's a different breed. Sam knew what he was there to do, and he kind of flipped the whole thing on Idubbbz' head. So that's what he's talking about, where he talked about the hit piece on Sam. And then what's funny is because Idubbbz couldn't put together the documentary in a way that would make Sam look bad, like, obviously he was just doing it to so he was doing it to make him look bad, but he didn't release it and then got a bunch of backlash, so he released it. I'm pretty sure is how that went.
And he thinks he's a fucking, like, mastermind. He definitely viewed me as a documentary subject, stepping stone, guy that he could eviscerate with his big brain in order to make 4chan stop calling him a cuck.
That was the plan.
That was his plan.
See, he's talking about it right fucking now.
And
it didn't fucking work.
Scorpion, because I flipped it on him when he came out here to make me look like an ass.
Yep, that's exactly what I said earlier. He fucking flipped that shit on him. I mean, I just said it right then, but like earlier when I was talking about how he made this, he was doing these documentaries. You know, he did, like I said, he did one on Airsoft Fatty, and then he did this one with Sam, and he actually didn't release it. And the only reason that he wound up releasing the one on Sam is because Sam Hyde did his own documentary and released that instead, and everybody watched that instead of the one that Idubbbz put out.
Ho. Try again, sweetie. It doesn't matter. Even your own family hates you, bitch. Anissa's family hits me up. Her family, I've been hit up by her family members talking shit about her. Even your own family hates you, bitch. What does that say about you and how fucked up you are? They said that you used your Alzheimer's father as a dramatic prop. That's what Creator Clash 1 was for. It was for Alzheimer's or something like that. And Anissa was up there like, I'm just so happy we could raise all this money for Alzheimer's. One of your own fucking family members hit me up and said you don't care that much about your father. And that your father, you have like a strained relationship or something. And that you don't care about Alzheimer's.
The way Idubbbz frames it...
I can definitely see that. I could definitely see people seeing the kind of money you can make in the creator space and then using something like that to... And then using something like that to... try to make some money off of it. And who knows if any of that money even went to charity anyway. It
is that Sam is saying this just to get to him, which removes her individuality and is actually very sexist. He also uses the term sex worker and woman interchangeably, the fucking pig.
Talk more about how sex workers are property. That's a funny joke. It was super funny the third time that you referred to women as property.
These women aren't your property. You don't own them. They can do what they want, and what they want is for you to own them. For $30. Why does Idubbbz hate Sam Hyde so much? Well, I'll tell you. Idubbbz does not hate Sam. He hates what Sam represents. Sam Hyde is a physical manifestation of all of Idubbbz's guilt and regret. Idubbbz has spent years separating himself from the edgy content under the philosophy that doing edgy content will eventually lead you to destroying your entire life. So in order to prove his philosophy, he does a documentary on Sam Hyde, a man who seemingly perfectly proves the idea. Through refusal to rehabilitate his image, Sam Hyde lost his Adult Swim show, and he got completely banned off the internet. But the documentary doesn't go how he wanted it to go. Instead of a tragedy of a guy who'd fallen off, he got a comedy prank show. And after being forced into a position where he has to release the footage, he adds a bunch of hastily edited segments where he says that every racist joke or thing that Sam has ever said is actually a real belief that Sam holds, and he's being...
See, that's what I was talking about. Sam released his version, so he had his own person there filming and stuff, released his version of this documentary, and then Idubbbz had to release his. Because as far as I know, he wasn't planning to release it. He was just planning on just letting, like, all right, we're just going to let it die. But then Sam was like, no. I'm going to release mine, and I'm going to show everybody the truth that he was just there to try to, like, make a fool of him or whatever. Or however you want to put it, but yeah, he wasn't going to let that shit slide, so honestly, it's just like, it's not a good look for him, because you can't have like made yourself famous like that, and then all the people know you for being, you know, for being this edgy person. Sorry, hold on a second. Let's see if it's back. And then just expect people to like you or like this new version of you, which the reason people don't is because you don't seem genuine. You're not genuine about it. You don't actually fucking believe this stuff, as evidenced by the calling the one dude Pusanabe. I mean, that was the old you, man. You're right there. Like I said at the beginning. Very beginning of watching this video, and actually I made this joke I made this joke before with one of my buddies that literally I don't say it as like, you know, to dog on his wife at all, because I don't need to do that. Obviously the internet's already doing it enough for me, but the pussy changed him, you know what I'm saying? You know, he finally got some top class pussy, and it fucking changed him, and he became pussy whipped. You know, that's where that phrase came from. You became pussy whipped. It's all right, bro. Just that's what happened, man. You gotta, you know, stick with that. You know what I'm saying? You got whipped by the pussy, and that's just what happened, my guy. Like, you know, there's no hate there. Hey, you know what, man? You know, you're fine with your girl having an OnlyFans because she's bad as fuck. You know what I'm saying? She's fine as fuck. You know what I'm saying? Just like, fucking own it, dude. Fucking own that shit.
Ironic. At this point, Idubbbz has realized his mistake. He's now accidentally put this irrelevant figure back into the spotlight. So he goes out of his way to...
So, yeah, so what was funny, right? If Sam Hyde was, like, falling off, Idubbbz going to do that documentary with him, and then Sam Hyde putting that documentary, his own version, out, blew up. I fucking saw it. I'd never heard of Sam Hyde before this shit happened, so...
never give him any spotlight ever again. By refusing to put him on the Creator Clash card, banning him from the event, removing all mention of him from Harley's training footage, specifically telling cameramen not to show people wearing Sam Hyde merch in the audience, and banning fighters who interact with Sam Hyde from future events. They make up a bunch of retard excuses, like saying he's a business risk. They'll do a 50-minute documentary on him, they'll fucking sell merch based on him, but God forbid they work with him when he can make a profit. Imagine abandoning all your passions and everything that gives you enjoyment in life because you think it leads to complete irrelevancy, only to then watch a guy attain massive success through the same content you abandoned and because...
I think it's just that, like, he was going away from that content, I wouldn't say already, but then he met his wife, and then his wife, like, I won't say brainwashed him, but, like, was almost in a way brainwashing him into being like, you can't do that kind of stuff anymore. And then it's hilarious that Sam's doing it. He's like, I'm so fucking pissed that I could have just kept being the same fucking person that I was and could be successful doing it.
You promoted him whilst trying to prove your point. At this moment, you realize all the sacrifices you made, the friends you abandoned, all the humiliation that you've put yourself through, and the destruction of your public image and legacy was all for nothing. You'd fucking hate Sam Hyde too. In conclusion, in 1999, serial killer Edward Carver kidnapped a woman named Cheryl Dempsey. He held her captive for 2 years. During her captivity, Cheryl was routinely sexually and physically abused by Carver. Cheryl was eventually found by the police. However, her ordeal had left her irreversibly damaged. She empathized with her captor, believing that he loved her. She became incapable of making independent decisions. She had to be told when to eat, sleep, or go to the toilet. 2 weeks after her rescue, she committed suicide. Her body was later exhumed by Carver. That's basically Idubbbz' marriage.
We are very fucking stupid to hold the word nigger at this colossally high standard.
It's not time. Make a change, just relax, take it easy.
See, he's disassociating because he's extremely depressed. Like, you disassociate when you're just sitting there and you just kind of drift off.
You're baby, damn serious! You fucking retard!
There's so much you have to know.
Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me. I am old, but I'm happy.
Great to see you. We're all really proud of you. This is fucking awesome. You're represented, though.
And I know
less stuff
that it's not easy
are not as smart or something.
To be calm.
What the fuck? A real racist? I didn't think we were going to see a real racist today. I didn't think you were going to see a real-life racist today.
Well, it's because my girlfriend is selling news on the internet.
He's taken her last name. He married in June with Idubbbz' last name changed from Washburn to Joma.
Get on your redemption arc.
What?
ASAP. People like seeing you lose because you suck, but it's getting tiresome, it's getting worn out, so now it's time to win. But you have to get all the tattoos lasered off, and you have to ditch your boner.
Do you think it's appropriate that, I don't know, 30-something-year-old man is publicly calling my wife a whore and a slut?
Grab fucking my wife, bankrupting.
My girlfriend started an OnlyFans account.
Appreciate it, man.
Yeah.
Because you're obviously got a bigger viewership.
Uh-huh.
And it's like your brand, you can't be messing around with people who are, like, unsafe.
It's that Anissa has changed me. Do you think it was cool when I was running around in an oversized cop outfit?
Pardon?
Yes! It was fucking hilarious! Because you were running around in an oversized fucking cop outfit. Pretending to be the police of the internet. When, like, the last person that should have been the police of the internet should have been Idubbbz. You know what I'm saying? That shit was funny.
Everything that she says, like, you know, for the most part, I'm down with.
As terrible as the Holocaust was, obviously it was horrendous, and how disgusting the doctor was. Found a couple of really groundbreaking discoveries.
I am now invulnerable to criticism.
Nothing worse than a slut who's ugly.
TOS.
I'll bust your teeth out, bitch.
I don't think it's appropriate that you are hanging out with a guy who doesn't think women are people.
Where she stood with it now.
She's fucking so gross. I don't find her attractive at all.
I think that's demeaning to women.
It's either all okay or none of it's okay.
I've changed for the worse. The person responsible for my change in a bad way is Anissa.
Ian, as a person, has not changed very much in like regards to his like moral stance on a lot of things.
He still would have lost to Dr. Mike even if he could breathe and didn't have fractures.
I think that was gonna happen.
That's what he always said.
My career on YouTube, so it's been, I don't know.
It was super funny the third time that you referred to women as property. That was the funniest one.
I was raised by a single mother till I was 10.
Rest in peace, Idubbbz. Let's everybody say a prayer for Idubbbz.
I love my girlfriend, and I'm totally fine with dudes jacking off to pictures.
I mean, listen. I feel bad for him because he changed when the funny thing is that if he would have just stayed the person he was, he would have been both happy and still been able to be successful. This wasn't a content cop, it was straight up police brutality. Yep. This is a good YouTube comment right here from Michael Hernandez. He said, Ethan making fun of the guy's mom dying and then Anissa crackling into the microphone is arguably worse than anything Sam Hyde has ever said about them. That is 100% a fact, okay? The stuff that Sam Hyde was saying, yeah, probably about punching her teeth out or whatever, is not probably not all right. But I don't really give a shit anyway because I don't give a fuck about them. But them laughing about somebody's mom dying is really fucked up. There is just a line that you just like don't cross, and they definitely cross. There's like, you know, I definitely cross a lot of lines in the stuff that I say or stuff that I joke about or like I make fun of stuff or I say things that sometimes cross the line. But even I realize that there are just some moments, there are just things that you say. Or there's just things that you just don't cross the line about, and somebody's family member, close family member passing away is one of those things that you just don't cross the line. Like that's a line you just don't cross. And it's hilarious that they will say that they're like, oh, we don't like this guy for the things he said. Well, I don't like you for the things you said. How about that? You just happen to be lucky that right now the woke culture is what everybody is going towards. Everybody has to be nice to each other, whatever. You know what? We were just fine back in 2016, and I think we'll continue to be just fine going forward. I also want to talk about this comment. It says, what the fuck? You're actually right. I didn't realize this. Idubbbz made a documentary on Sam Hyde not only to punk his old bully, but to prove that you must move on from the edgy phase. But even though Sam lost his Adult Swim show and maybe had some bad events happen, he stayed true to himself and didn't change to someone who everyone is trying to transform you to. Even if Sam Hyde loses more, at least he won't be unoriginal, which is truly a full victory. Now, I don't know about that, but it was something like what I was saying. I think what hurts Idubbbz more is that he realized that if he would have just stayed true to who he was, which was the edgy cringe lord, he'd be happier if he was the same person he was. And you want to be with somebody that is fine with who you are as a person. You can try to change who you are, but that, you know, to be somebody else, but that is who you were. Like, it's crazy, honestly. Leafy may not have a chin, but at least he has a spine. Facts. It's funny they picked on him for bullying, but that's all they do. I think it was a little different. Like, Leafy was punching down a lot of smaller content creators, and at the time, Okay, at the time, Leafy was like one of the biggest content creators. I wouldn't say biggest, but he was like one of the biggest like up and coming content creators on YouTube. His videos had tons of views. Like, I used to see his stuff pop up all the time. He was some of my second monitor content. But what happened was I would go to these channels, not to mess with them, but like I wanted to look at who these people were. I was like, what the fuck are they posting? Like, he made one on Badlands Chugs, the guy who can like chug shit like really quickly, which is fucking impressive, by the way. He did one on him. There was a couple of other people. The guy who used to dress with like he looked like Marilyn Manson, but he was like a Native American, and he used to he was like a singer or something. He did one on him. He was actually pretty cool. So but one thing that was nice is that like he would do these videos on all these small content creators, and it actually gave a lot of these small content creators a platform for people to find them. So, but then yeah, it's funny that they picked on him for bullying, or they did a content cop on him, essentially cancel him from YouTube. And then they go around and do the same thing. We defeated the wrong enemy. It's hilarious looking back on it now, but at the time, yeah, I do think it's I agree with this other person too. It's something I said. It's hilarious that the Sam Hyde documentary was supposed to be like, oh, look what happens when you stay politically incorrect, and then it actually brought a renaissance to his career. It's hilarious. I love it, honestly. And honestly, if Idubbbz would have just stayed, you either live long enough to either die a hero or live long enough to see yourself become the villain. It's hilarious how that statement stays true, honestly. And all the content cops are gone. I don't think they're on his channel anymore. All of these have been re-uploaded to other channels. Oh yeah, and then Jinx Reloaded as well. Shout out to Bigbunjeeeeee. Fantastic fucking video. I absolutely loved it. I'm gonna go. I don't know if I can go to my YouTube studio on here because I'm streaming on my other computer right now. But dude, it was an awesome video, and I think that really kind of hit the nail on the head of all of the drama that's come up surrounding Idubbbz. And honestly, it's kind of sad because he was like the last of like the bastion of like, honestly, a lot of those content creators from that era, Ethan Klein from H3H3, Idubbbz, Keemstar, I said Max Mofo and Filthy Frank earlier, they kind of were like just doing their own thing. A lot of those content creators have kind of just died off. Like, they don't really like do, like, people still watch H3H3, but is it for the same reasons that they used to? I would argue no. But I mean, yeah, overall that was a pretty good video, and yeah, I wish I would have stopped my stream and done another one instead, but yeah.